Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let me show you how to turn your iPad into a second screen for your Mac. So there are several apps that do this, but I use the one called Air Display. And what you do is you install the app Air Display on your iPad. And then you install some software on your Mac that allows it to see the iPad on the same Wi-Fi network as another display. And then you can use your iPad as a second display with your Mac. Now this is going to be slower and it's not going to be as convenient as actually having a second display. And displays are pretty cheap. So it's not something you probably want to use at your desk in your office or at home. But it's very handy if you just want to occasionally have a second monitor and you don't want to buy another piece of equipment, or if you travel a lot and you've got your MacBook and you want to have the luxury of having a second screen and you're already carrying your iPad with you. So why not use it as a second display? So the first thing you need is you need to search for Air Display in the iTunes App Store for your device. So you can do that right on the iPad if you want. You can see right now it's $10. Of course, prices always vary in the store. And you buy that and download it. Then you want to go on your Mac to the website, which is avatron.com. You get a link to it when you have the app. And then you go to Air Display. And in there you can download the software you need for your Mac. There's also software for Windows as well, so you can do the same thing. So this is a free download. You download and install these drivers. So here I have my MacBook Air and my iPad 4th Gen, and they're both working on the same Wi-Fi network. And I've got the AirPlay app installed over here in the iPad, and I'm going to run that to get ready. And I've got it switched to Mac instructions. I don't think it really matters. It's just the instructions there. Basically, the app just sits there and waits for a connection, and in the meantime, you can view all sorts of instructions to help you get going. On the Mac, I've got the AirPlay software installed, and I'm going to go to System Preferences, and then down at the bottom System Preferences I now have under Other Air Display. So I click on that. You can see I've got it turned off now. Before I turn it on, I'm going to review my settings and see that, okay, I have Retina Display turned off, and I have everything else set the way I want. So I can go back to Connect. I can turn on Air Display, and now I can select a device. Now, it can be a lot easier if you do this a lot to turn on the menu bar option, and then you get a lot of this right up here and you don't have to go to System Preferences to do it. You can see that both up here and over here I've got the iPad 4th generation. It notices it there. That's my name for that iPad, so that's why it comes up like that. Now I can select it. When you do, the screen's kind of refresh, just like when you're, say, hooking up an external monitor. And now I've got this screen over here, and you can see I can drag and drop windows. It works just like an external monitor. As a matter of fact, if you go to Show All in System Preferences and Displays, it sees it as just a regular monitor. So System Preferences is none the wiser. It sees there's the iPad right there. I can even do something like mirror the displays, and then it'll refresh. Now I've got mirrored displays there, and if I don't have them mirrored, I can rearrange them. So say, you know, right now I move the cursor or drag a window to the right, and you'll see it appears there like that. But if I wanted to, say, move it over to the left, I could. And now, of course, it'll work like this. But that would be how I'd want it if I had my iPad on the opposite side of the MacBook. Now let's look at using the Retina display with it. So let's go down to Air Display here, and in Settings, let's change it to use Retina resolutions. And now it's going to reset here, and we'll see what happens is, of course, the graphic extends across the entire iPad, so you don't notice any difference at the beginning. But if I were to drag this over here, you can see I now have twice the resolution over here. So hard to work with since the pixels are so small, but it could be ideal if, say, one of you photographs or something on this side, you have all that resolution. So now here I am running text edit, and I can move this over here to this screen. And you can see I could first of all, I can tap on it to move the cursor. So you can see the cursor moves wherever it is I'm tapping, and I can also bring up the keyboard and use the keyboard to type. And the cool thing is, of course, it doesn't have to be on the screen here. Let's see, I can tap to drag,
See, it's a little difficult to tap to drag, but it can be done. And I can pick up where that left off with the mouse. And I can still type here on the right. And so I can basically use my iPad kind of as an external keyboard, even if the stuff's on the screen. So it gives you lots of options for doing things any way you want to do them. And here you can see I have the displays mirrored. So I can actually still type with the keyboard here on the iPad when I want, and it doesn't interrupt the screen on the MacBook.
There's some really interesting possibilities in this. For instance, if you were to mirror your display on your iPad, you could hand your iPad to somebody, say a client you were talking to, and then you could basically drive a presentation on your MacBook and they could watch it on their iPad instead of having to look over your shoulder. Of course, don't expect fantastic performance because you're piping the entire video stream over Wi-Fi. That's many times slower than a direct connection using a dedicated video cable. So you're not going to get things updating. You're not going to be able to play games or anything close to the speed of that. But it's great for, say, putting a browser window over there, putting some palettes over there if you're working, say, in a program like Photoshop, things like that. Maybe even putting Twitter and Facebook over on that so you can keep an eye on them while you get your work done on the main screen. So I hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.